Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. I am, of course, Dr. Curry, and I'm all alone here in the COD booth, but that's all right. We right now in the Rose, we have an amazing game we just could not miss up, and we have to show you guys. It is Avant versus Phoenix Uprising, and they are in game number two. It is Search and Destroy on Meltdown, and Avant did take away game number one, which was Raid Hardpoint. So we have to, you know, keep it in the back of our mind coming into this game. Avant are winning, but it's such two of the best teams going around right now. So we had to jump in and show you guys. And we'll be going on board with Vileside. He's just trying to take out a player there. Vamp getting an early snipe off. And 1 minute left on the clock. It is, of course, the fourth round. In case we, not even I know, but we'll bring up the scoreboard just as Vileside gets shut down. But look at that. Three kills to Vileside and Vamp. Hopi and Enigma doing a great job. Physique doing some work for the Phoenix team, but no one else really doing anything else. But these two teams right now are some of the best going around. They were on the main stage before, so we have to keep that in mind. Physique does have the bomb in a, it's a one on two situation. Enigma left alive for the Avant squad. They are up by one round as he is spotting a player up on top there, unable to get any shots really off to him, as it looks like this team of Phoenix are going to be rotating around to this hard, to the next B, sorry, the B bomb site. It's going to be Physique trying to plant the bomb there. MMS trying to scope through that wall. Unable to spot anyone. But here comes Enigma from behind. Take him out. He knows where the bomb's down. 9 seconds left. He's just going to run. And this is going to force Ledges to go for the plant, which he will make it. 1-on-1. 44 seconds on the scoreboard. It's going to be very interesting to see who can walk away. We have to go on board with Enigma. He's on the free kill streak. Knows the player somewhere around him. Both of them rotating all around the place. And what a legend. Or legends for the Phoenix squad. He's trying to find him. He needs to do a legendary effort right now. With only 25 seconds left, it does take 7.5 to the fuse. And Enigma comes around looking the wrong way. And I can hear them going off in the middle of the floor down there. 2-2 is the score. And we look at the kill cam. Unfortunately, Enigma looking the wrong way. And Legends punishing him for it. Great job by Legends there to hold his composure and give them the round. But score's level 2-2 now. And we will jump on board with one of the Avant players. How about we go as Hopi? Haven't shown him much love lately, but he, of course, is an ex-Halo pro, rotated over to Call of Duty not too recently, and he has taken the game, you know, in such a strive. And I have just been informed I will be joined by another co-caster. It will, of course, be the one and only Mikester94, so we'll try to get him set up. But as of right now, Hopi, with that scope still, trying to find any of the players, and he's just not spotting any of them. And here he is, the legend, Mikester. Why don't you introduce yourself?
How's it going, guys? Yeah, interesting matchup. I was watching down on the floor, and it's going crazy. Both games underway, of course. Winners of these matches will go on, you know, to play each other in the next matchup. And we have the scope there from Hopi, nearly getting killed, narrowly missing it. We have Vileside right next to him. They need to make a play here on this B bomb site. They're looking for it, and they already know they're there. There'll be C1 on that turbine. We'll get the kill. We have Hopi taking out Physique. 3v2 situation. Avant with the numbers.
Physique not in the situation you want to be, but look at that. It seems like Hopi had connection interrupted. I'm not too sure what's going on there. I think he might have had some Xbox lag or something. But Vileside, the left, last one alive with the bomb down. Two players left alive. Swanee and Trent trying to finish it off here. They really want to get this win under their belts. And oh my god, massive kills by Swanee. He's going off on the stage there. And if we just look at the score streaks, it looks like they're going to give it to Trent, even though Swanee was close to those score streaks. Not too sure about their thinking there, Mikester.
Yeah, well, they are playing so far so good, as it is going round for round. We are looking right now. We have a man of Swanee getting that round ending kill cam on Vileside. He's getting those nice shots where he needed to put them. And just like that, 3-2, the score will become, as it's nearly halfway in terms of rounds. Of course, it is first to six. So nearly 3-2, you know, round six at the moment. And we'll jump on board. And we'll stay on board with Trent, see what he can do, as, you know, they're going to mix it up a little bit here. But it's still going to be interesting to watch how they're going to play it. Both teams are playing absolutely amazing.
Oh, look at that sensor grenade. I'm not too sure which Avant player threw that, but it would have given identity to two other players for the Phoenix Uprising squad. Now, we are bored with Trent. He is personally one of my favorite players to watch. I just personally think he is an amazing overall player. And Swanee is calling it an RC car right now. He's just going to bait it through A, try to spot any of the players there. then give notification to his teammates. And we will see them starting to push up. One player is in there at 20. They're going to start to make a very aggressive push there. His teammate catching him off guard there. But Hopi dropping for Zeke there. If we look at it, two players down for Avant. Swanee still alive for Phoenix Uprising. And I can definitely see Phoenix Uprising walking away with this round.
Well, it's in the numbers to win, but you know, anything could happen. We do have Hopi and Enigma left alive for the team of Avant. We hear a couple of gunshots going off. And everyone's contesting over near this A-bomb as Hopi's going to take out Trent Swan's going to take out Enigma. And Hopi, you know, he has that 1v2. Let's jump on board with him. See what he can do. You know, they're going to be wanting for this bomb plant. Oh. As Hopi takes out Legends, he has the 1v1 left. And 12 seconds to make something happen. You know, the bomb still hasn't gone down. And I'm not too sure if it'll even be able to. And too late now, as we see where Hopi is. He needs to be careful right here. As he'll get the kill.
Oh, my God. Swanee.
Get the round. Hopi should have just maybe just bailed on that one. He's going to be regretting that now as we see that round in the kill cam.
Wow. Oh, Swanee. Yeah, I had to question him not putting that bomb down. But he did come across the Avant player right in front of him. With less than 1 second left. He did an amazing job bringing it 4-2 in favor of Phoenix Uprising. They are, of course, one down in the series. So if they were to walk away with the search and destroy, they would level it up and make it 1-1.
Exactly right. And, you know, it still is anyone's game, as we mentioned. You know, S&D is one of those great game types where anything could happen, even if they're, you know, 5-0 up, can still come back to win it. That's what's so great about that S&D game type. Now, we do have Avant, of course, on the attacking team. And they're the ones that need to make something happen. They're on the back foot here. And we just have to really wait and see if they'll be able to do anything really, as we do have a bit of a slow push that I'm used to seeing, you know, from Vilesider. And, you know, they're looking like they're playing this B side, as of course the team of the Phoenix Uprising already know that.
Oh my.
It's going to be interesting.
This is going to be so interesting. The whole of Avant are in the open. Swanee does have score streaks, but he does have support from his teammates. Of course, two players left alive. Make that one. Last player will be Enigma, who has to do something now. Players go for the defuse on the bomb. He spots 1, 2, 3 of them. Actually, unfortunately, he didn't go for that player. Went for the player going for the defuse, which he had to do. But then turned around was Trent, who ended up cleaning him up there. And they will get to defuse. One round away is Phoenix Uprising from tying the series 1-1.
Exactly right. And that one map to tie things up, that one round could be, you know, their momentum that they need. Anything could happen, of course. And it's all about the mental game this late into the competition. Now we are onto our final games, of course. But man, it is going to be close.
It is going to be so close. Remember, these players right now are fighting for their lives. The winner will advance into the losers round and potentially face off against Envy in the losers final. And then from there, the winner of that will go into the grand final. So teams, they need all the rounds they can get. Avant, they need to go big now. Just had to go on board with some Vamp. He's doing a very aggressive push, but Swanee still has those score streaks, which he's just caught in as I switched over to him. He would have given the call out, but Vamp takes out Trent and Swanee takes out Vilesider too. The Lightning Strike unable to pick up any of the players there. He just saw the shadow of one of the players. That will be Avant Hopi in the middle of the map there. Look at that sniper shot.
Tries to get one and just can't connect at the moment. Better luck next time. But, you know, there might not be next time, of course, as the bomb has gone down over near this B bomb site. Now, they need to make something happen. It is a 3v3 situation. And it's all about if they'll be able to make some plays happen. As Vamp gets taken down, making that into a 3v2. As 1v3 for Hopi to take. He has the DSIs getting shots fired at him. He gets the tag.
No.
And he will get taken down by Legends. You can hear them going off. And that should tie things back up.
Wow. That's I got to feel for Hopi there. That's got to be so demoralizing to get a hit marker like that. And that will, in fact, tie the series 1-1. Phoenix Uprising, of course, versus Avant Garde. And it is a best of five series. The next map we will see will, in fact, be from the sheet I have in front of me. It will be CTF on standoff. So we will be back shortly live at Plantonics ACL Melf in 2013 with the Call of Duty 4v4 Championship. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everyone, to Plantronics ACL Melbourne. I am, of course, Dr. Curry, and I am here with the wonderful Mikester94. Why don't you say hello to everyone, Mikester?
How's it going, everyone? Now, as you already know, we do have Avant taking on Phoenix Uprising, and what a match has been so far.
It has been amazing. We were busy with the main stage performance. We tuned into the game, and it was halfway through the Search and Destroy on Meltdown. Apparently, Avant did take out the raid in what was called a close... You'd agree with me, a close quarters match?
Yeah, pretty much. And, you know, I was watching the main stage earlier on, down on the floor, and then I was, you know, you could hear them in the background as well. Both games going on, of course. We do have the Insurgency versus Capital Punishment, which I believe might have just finished as well. I'm not too sure on that one. And hopefully starting up the Capture the Flag on Standoff here. Now, hopefully soon. I think we had some issue, maybe some classes or something.
Yeah.
Still need to get done. Who knows? But it is one apiece, I believe, the last time I did check. And, you know, Capture the Flag coming up next.
Capture the Flag on Standoff. It's probably one of the more dominant game types on Standoff, of course. You will see a lot of cutoffs, a lot of pulling on the very outer edges of the map. Of course, I will be back alley and through Tractor. Very rarely you'll see players go through the hearts of Standoff. But you're going to see a lot of cutoffs, a lot of spawn predicting and manipulating by both teams.
And what's more important, I get to say Standoff on Standoff again.
Standoff on
hopefully,
Standoff.
Hopefully.
Well, I don't really enjoy it, but we've seen it time and time again where both teams have each other's flags. And, of course,
it's always entertaining to say it, though. As we are starting up now with the game itself, hopefully being able to actually stay on board. This time, of course, we do have the Capture the Flag, as we've mentioned countless times, and nope. Maybe third time's the charm, though.
Maybe third time is a charm. This is like the third time they've done it. Unfortunately, someone they don't know might have accidentally connected. But it happens. You know, they're down on the ground floor. Stuff happens. But basically, now you were in the guts of it. You were watching the first map, which was Raid Hardpoint. Who for the Avant squad do you think performed the best during that round?
Well, to be honest, I can't really say I was really paying attention to that much of the game, as I was watching the main stage action that we did see with Immunities match up against Envy. But we did have, you know, the Avant match playing on in the background. I could only really hear voices, as you do, of course, have the Insurgency one there as well. So I can't really tell you that one. But, you know, it does. If it's a 1-1 scoreline, you know, it would have been an intense match judging what we saw by that S&D.
Definitely. And that game against Immunity versus Envy, if you guys weren't around for it, Shox dropped a 23 kill streak. It was just phenomenal. I was up here casting with a special guest. You guys go check it out in the previous broadcast. It was amazing. But now we are, of course, in game number 3 of the series. It is going to be Capture the Flag on Standoff, Avant Grade versus Phoenix Uprising.
Exactly right, and we'll stay on board with Vamped up first, as we'll see what he can do. Gets a couple shots off, getting tagged off into that bottom wood area. Won't be able to connect. The Swanee will take out Enigma. Kazeek's going to take out Hopi. And only 15 seconds, you know. Still no one's really made any sudden movements as Vamp needs to be careful right here. As shots going off and he will take out Trent there. As Hopi will take out Kazeek at the same time. One to top Trent is.
Oh my god.
But no, he won't be able to get the kill. But we jump on board with Vilesider right now as he does have this flag in hand. And they're going to try to stop him, but a very good spawn there from the Avant side.
Avant, of course, as I said, stand off such a dominant CTF map. You will see lots of spawn predicting and manipulating as that flag was just run in by Vilesider there. Less than a minute. Again, we see another flag. I'm sorry, if any of you haven't been tuning in, all flags have literally been being pulled at this event in the first minute. Just sorry, we'll just switch over to Topia as I talk about this, but teams are just getting these flags from the enemy's base to their own in less than a minute, always in the first round.
Yeah, we've seen that count happen countless times. Of course, not all of them. However, a majority of the ones we've had on stream have been. But, you know, we did have Trent picking up the flag earlier on, and in a split second, he got taken down. The Legend's giving it another shot, and he's going halfway at least so far. Should be able to get this one. He has a couple in front of him.
Oh.
The flag will be dropped now, and they're all closing in. It will be picked up again by Physique. He gets
Physique.
Swanee actually helps him out there, but we have one there. And he'll get there. Vilesider with the double, but he'll get taken down. That flag is still down, but Trent gets taken down as well. They need to get this return. Maybe Legends is holding it off.
Legends going massive there. You saw Vilesider was an insane two-piece. He did clutch it there, but was unable to sprint out of the way and got taken down there. But what a just Avant. They pulled that back brilliantly, switched the tables, and then got to pull the flag their own time. And look at that. Vilesider did end up picking up a Hellstorm from that run.
Exactly, and that's going to come into play later on, of course, as he's shooting into Courtyard right now. And, you know, two of the Avant members are down at the moment. He's getting shots through into Kebab, and he'll get the kill on Legend. And now he will get taken down as well through Swanee. Swanee makes it a double to taking out Enigma. We'll jump aboard to him, see what he can do. Checking the smoke over. Pushing forward now onto the flag. Spots one on their staircase in Grannies. Gets tagged on. We'll get taken down, though, by Vamped. And Vilesider will pick up a kill on Trent.
Physique also pushed up. He's going to try and take out Enigma there. But Hopi, he's pulled the flag for Avant. And look at him. He's just running straight through the guts of standoff. Trying to throw that flash grenade. Unable to connect with anyone. Players dropping around the place. Vilesider, he picks up the flag there. He's going to be sprinting past all players for this lineup of Phoenix Uprising are all around their base. Flag has been pulled, but massive kills going down. Van taking out a big kill and trying to get the two-piece. My God, Physique, he pulled out full score streaks and just went massive just then.
That was an extremely good play. You know, Vilesider predicting where one person would go. They tried to box him in and, you know, it didn't work out for them. But we do have Physique with all his streaks at the moment. They're going to come into play. He's getting flashed at the moment. As you see by the minimap, they are collapsing in as Hopi picks off Physique. Legend's going to take out Hopi and Enigma's going to take out Legends. As Swanee takes out Enigma. So these kills are just trading in left, right, and center. We'll jump on board with Vilesider. Of course, you've got to keep in consideration streaks are in the hands of either team as Trent did try to pick up the flag. Got demolished straight away as Vilesider gets the kill on Physique. And he's pushing straight forward. Hope he's going to cover his back. There's one on the flag. And he should be able to get this one in to make it 2-0.
You know what? This game has been so evenly contested the whole time. But if you look at the scoreboard, Avant 2-0. We'll bring up the actual scoreboard while we're at it. And in all honesty, the scoreboard doesn't really explain how close quarter this map has been, even though two flags are in favor of Avant.
Exactly, Ryan will jump on board with Trent as he did get taken down. So we'll have to see, the flag has been returned. But you know, it's still early days. It is only the first half, 50 seconds remaining, and Physique with the kill on Vent, but he will get taken down by Hopi. Vilesider on a 3 kill streak as well. Hopi's in top green at the moment, rotating out. He's tagged heavily, so he needs to back out, regain some health, make another play, make another option. Of course, they are leading 2-0. So far, the team of Avant. And as we mentioned earlier, the score is 1-1 overall. In terms of maps, we do have the man of Vilesider still with the 3 kill streak. If we look on board, we're on board with Legends at the moment. And we see on the mini map, the Avant team are playing defense for the remaining 18 seconds of this first half. And Doctor, what are your thoughts so far?
Look, this game has been so evenly contested. Avant, they may have the two flags up to their name, but Phoenix Uprising have done a magnificent job all game long. They just haven't looked as strong at key points, and in the end, they did end up getting those two flags against them. But in all honesty, coming into another half of the CTF, it is of course 2 rounds, 5 minutes to a piece. I definitely can see this Avant squad possibly getting another flag and taking the victory, or Phoenix Uprising making a comeback and just upsetting Avant.
Well, we just have to wait and see on this second half as it is starting on down. We do have Physique, though, still with those streaks.
There it is.
Covering up with those trophy systems. And we'll jump on board. Let's see who else has streaks into the game. If there is anyone, we have, you know, we have, I believe that was Vamp, who was close. But we do have all the other members, you know, don't have any streaks so far. We have Volslider and Physique, though, in the hands. We'll have to see what they're going to do as Legends picks off Hopie. 20 seconds so far passed in this second half. But it still is anyone's game. Of course, those two flags can be caught up within this second half. It's just all about if they'll be able to do it. We have Trent now with the flag in hand. And let's see if we can jump on board with him and see what he can do.
But Killstreak's just quickly comes in. That lightning, the Hellstorm missile from Valsada. Take him out. He is just 1 kill away from picking up that lightning strike, which could be a game changer, which he just does there. Valsada on a kick, 6 kill streak. He shut down that flag pull from Trent there. Physique, massive 2-piece by him. With the 3-piece also, he just took out Trent, dropping Hopi too. Look at this lineup for Phoenix Uprising. They're actually doing such an amazing job, but they haven't been able to cap any flags.
Well, that's exactly the point. It is an objective game type, so that's what they need to do. Go for the objective. They've been close so many times, they just haven't been able to close things off. As Swanee gets the double on two of the Avant members, Enigma and Hopi, and you know, Physique still has those streaks. If we just do a quick swap around to all the players, let's see if anyone else is in possession of some streaks. And we do still have Volslider actually getting his further streak, so he might have repeated the lightning strike.
That war machine.
Maybe. And he has the war machine, as you just mentioned, so you know that's going to come into play. He's on a 7-kill streak at the moment. Hope he's going to get the kill on Legends. Still 3:20 remaining in this second half. And it's looking like Avant are the favorites.
Avant definitely destroying right now in terms of map domination. But Physique does have that sentry gun still at the back of the map. So it's very interesting to see just how little map control they do have right now, as he just gets dropped by Enigma there. He's going to be going for a very aggressive push towards their base. Valsada is still on that 7-score streak. Flag pulled by Trent there. He's going to be running straight through the middle of the map. But Valsada, that war machine just tore him a new one. Amazing job by him. He will be the last one alive for his Avant squad. This flag has been picked up by Swanee, who is going straight down the middle of the map. Here comes a Hellstorm missile to try and give him some support, but Valsada answers right back with that lightning strike. Amazing job by him. He is on the 9-kill streak, but just gets dropped just inches away. Valsada, he's lining up that flag. Oh my god, can he actually clutch it? No, he can't. 2-1. Amazing job by Phoenix Uprising. 2:20 left. They can definitely make the comeback here.
That was very well done by both of those teams. Valsada doing an amazing job to just hold on for his team. You know, made them drop the flag, and he has an 11 kill streak to boot. Still has that war machine in hand. Played that extremely effectively to pick off the kill early on, I believe it was Swanee who was running this flag. And you know, we still do have Valsada. Finally, his streak has been ended by Trent. Swanee's going to take out Hopi. Still 2-1, 2 minutes remaining in this second half. I still think Avant will take this one out, but they need to hold strong as Trent does pick up the flag, but will get taken down.
Unfortunate there, Trent went for it, but got shut down immediately. 1:45 is on the score. They need one flag to tie it up and potentially get another name back on their series, another point. It is, of course, 1-1, best of 5 series, 1-3. Whoever wins this will get an advantage coming in to the next search and the next hardpoint game, which will, in fact, be on Yemen, which is a map no one really likes to see, but it's in the rotation there. Vamp doing an amazing job on a 4-score streak, pushing up to the enemy base there. He's trying to get shots on the player. Smoke in his way, manages to get Trent. Trent is desperately trying to get these flags out, but not doing a very good job. Physique, he's going to be pushing up there, Vamped on the 5-score streak now. And it looks like Physique doesn't in fact pick up that flag though. Ran right past it though, knows there's a player above him. That's going to be Vamped on a 6-kill streak right now, Mike.
I'm personally getting nervous myself. These teams are just going at it. We have Enigma with the flag in hand, and I believe that's Physique as well, who might have picked it up. I believe I saw that on the right. There we go. Yes, so it's going to be, like I said, we finally get a chance to say it, a standoff on standoff.
Oh, God.
And 45 seconds in counting. Avant just need to play defense.
That flag.
They just need to hold this one off. It has been dropped. This one, he's going to pick it up. All kill streaks going in from Vamped. And Enigma's going to pick up a kill on Legends as well. Physique's going to pick up the flag. Still 30 seconds. They need to go. They're getting desperate here for this one. They're running down.
There's a player right there.
They need to take out, but the flag will be returns. At the moment, we have Enigma with his flag. He's going to be gunning for it. Of course, he still has enough time. He just needs to buy a couple more seconds. But that's just like it. This a map, but done and dusted with the 3-1 scoreline. Very well played by the advanced side. 22-9 for Vilesider.
Look, Vilesider, man of the match, definitely. He did get that 11 kill streak. He literally jumped in the start of round two and didn't die for at least 3/4 of it. Did an amazing job. And Enigma sealing the deal there was in the final kill cam too, but he did cap that flag, which did meant GG right there. And that is going to bring it 2-1 in favor of Avant coming in to the next map, which will in fact be Hardpoint Yemen. And ladies and gentlemen, you should stay tuned. This is an amazing series going on right now. And we are of course live at Plantronics ACL Melbourne 2013.
Welcome back with the Avant versus Phoenix Uprising matchup here. We got Hardpoint Yemen up now, and we're on board with Swanee at the moment to see what he can do. Nade's going off right next to him as Physique picks off the first kill on a Vamp, and Vilesider will get taken down in this well as Swanee will pick off Hopi and Enigma picks off Trent.
Look, Avant, they are on the 2-1 advantage coming into this game. I did just check my Twitter before. Lots of tweets going out in favor of this Phoenix Uprising. People wanting the comeback. They really want to see them make it the distance and face off against Immunity in the finals. I think that's what lots of people are rooting for, except for Avant. They want to win this. They want to finish it right now.
It's funny you say that, because my Twitter feed was all Avant. So, you know, it's definitely interesting to see how this one will play out. We go fans on either side, and we're going to jump on board with the man of Volsider as he cleans up the remaining 15 seconds. No, it will get contested. He's in the back, but he will get taken down by Trent. We do have Trent just going to milk the last 5 points before it does rotate over to Treehouse, and it is 22-18 with 1 minute just flying past.
Ooh, it is the first hill rotation, which is one not many players will be looking for that much time. Oh, Trent doing an amazing job at a Volsider coming from behind and taking him out. Great job there, but of course, not many players will be looking for, you know, a lot of time off that middle hard point. Instead, they will be looking for map control. You know, that's mainly what you want, especially in hard point. If you get good map control, good spawns, you can easily rack up great time. But look at this. Vamped, he's got the MK jewel band out. Why not, he says, as he is eating kids alive right now. He's on a 6-kill streak, trying to make it 7, but gets shut down. Very interesting. I'm just going to switch on board to him. Such an interesting class setup.
I think he just loves doing things out of the norm. We run snipers on hardpoint and CTF, so why not the MK48 as well? Why not, he says, as he still puts it to work, tries to get the kill, won't be able to pick off that time. Maybe next time, though, as Volsider will take out Physique, and the Legends will clean up a kill on Vamp. This one, he will take out Volsider, and Trent takes out Hopi. Now we still have 3 seconds till it rotates over to this market hardpoint, and we do have Team of Phoenix Uprising already there. We have Trent nearly to his streaks. We have one actually in the Spices area for, you know, both teams there. They're standing off. They know they're there. And Killstreak's going in now as well as the Avant side get it.
Wow.
Nearly a team down as Enigma takes
out. You know, they took out half their team, but they did in the meantime take out the whole of Phoenix Uprising. And they will now have control of this hard point. 5 seconds separating the two teams. Such a close game already. Enigma doing the OBJ work, has that Hellstorm missile in his back pocket, doing some work because that MSMC, another player trying to contest him there. That's going to be Physique, who goes massive. Massive was that B23R. He's on a 2-kill score streak. Halfway to the streaks, just playing a little bit more passive now. And look at these two teams already starting to rotate over to this Church hardpoint.
Yeah, and it's only been 3 minutes so far on this hardpoint, Yemen, and what a game so far. Let's bring up the scoreboard just to have a quick rundown. Every CD, I'm not going to run through all of them, but you see all of them are getting their kills. The ones that aren't are playing that OBJ, and they're playing extremely well, each and every single member of this game. Now we have Enigma just watching in this hardpoint. Of course, it has rotated over to Church. We have one going around as Legends gets the double.
Oh my god,
I'd hope
the
he didn't even
triple
rest the third.
Hit
no,
marker.
He will get taken down by Vamp. Vamp says that's enough. But still, Phoenix Uprising and Avant are contesting in this
Look
Church at the moment.
Volsider
with the double gets the triple.
Oh my god, Volsider just went massive with the three piece with the shotgun inside that close quarters hill. He just went off. He knows that he's 1 kill away from score streaks. He just, you know, the perk was removed from Call of Duties, but I swear that guy's got one man army on because he just took it all on and did an amazing job trying to get that two piece. But Trent, unfortunately, shutting him down there. Wow. All I can say is wow.
That was just in the period of 1 minute, and it is 98-88, or round about under 10 points.
So
the
even.
Difference. 5 minutes, 45 seconds remaining as the team of Avant have hit the triple digits mark right now. We still have Volsider in this courtyard or statue hardpoint. Still has the shotgun. Will get taken down. Got a nice tag, though, on Physique, I believe it was. And now Physique will get taken down by Hopi as we have Trent there with the Remington as well, as he'll pick off the kill. Swanee gets one as well.
Oh.
Trent makes it a double to take out Enigma.
Full score
as his streaks. They're going to come into play. Let's do a quick run around and see if anyone else has streaks, but of course we do have the team of
Enigma.
Phoenix Uprising hitting those triple digits as well.
Oh, look at that, Vamped and Enigma, they both have score streaks. Vamped, he does have that sentry gun and the Hellstorm missile, but so does Enigma. Volsider, he's also got one. He's going big in the hill again with that shotgun, but
missed that
shot there. And we'll just switch around. Only one player for the Phoenix Uprising squad has score streaks. That's going to be the sentry gun and the lightning strike. Enigma just went massive with 3 kills there, rotating over to this middle hardpoint. He's going to get support from Volsider with the shotgun. Grenade hit markers, a little bit unfortunate. They play a jump again. He just eats him alive. Swanee, what are you doing, son? Legends taking out Volsider. Look at this. Oh my god. Amazing job by Legends for the Phoenix Uprising squad. He just went massive, just said, breaking the hill. You know, the scores are so even. 4.5 minutes. In the end, I'm going to call it. If one team can get full control of one hill, I can see them walking away with the victory.
Yeah, well, it is 128-115. The rotation has reset. And it is back in this original one as Trent will pick off Enigma. Legends takes out one. Vamp takes out another and Hopi gets a double. Bossano will pick off Hopi though. That's not what you want. But still, if they want to do it, why not? We still have Vamp now having a couple of score streaks on his belt. And we do have, I think, a couple other members as well, as we do have Avant yet again in control. 8 seconds. Kill streaks going in. Unable to pick off any kills. Nearly takes out Vamp as we do have Volside again taken down by Legend. Swanee's going to take out Enigma. And Legend's going to take out Vamp. As you saw there on your screen, Hopi's there in a treehouse at the moment trying to get the kills, but it will get taken down by Swanee. Can you hear that in the background?
You can hear them going off. Unfortunately, you guys can't, but we can hear them in the back of our ear sets. They are just losing it down there. With look at this, Legend's trying to get the fifth one, but just gets shut down. Let's switch over to him. Obi's going to be trying to push this heal there, but unfortunately just got dropped. Enigma trying to get the grenade in there. Player jumping in front. That's going to be for Zeke. He's going to be pushing that top area, but gets shut down immediately. That would have been what a Legend's inside the hill right now for Zeke. He's going to be pushing two grenades coming in from both teams. The scores are equal. Phoenix Uprising do take the lead in a matter of a second. 20, in fact, the hill rotate over to top market.
Yeah, and as you mentioned, Phoenix Uprising have taken the lead, and that's the first time I believe they've done so, or at least not in a while. Now, we still do have Varsider already in this next, or in this current hardpoint. As we look into the mini-map here, we do have killstreaks going in from the team of Avant to clean up the guy on the market. And that was on Physique and Enigma with the killstreak, as Varsider will be calling in his Hailstorm at the moment. Trying to pick off Spices, and he'll get the kill on Swanee. And Trent takes out Varsider as he's calling in his killstreak. But we still have Vamp in this market at the moment. He's with there with Enigma. They're just trying to hold things off. He's 45 seconds as he did just rotate. He'll pick off the kill on Trent. One pushes in. And he'll take out Physique, but Legends will take out Vamp, still going off. Their Legends now gets the double to take out Vamp and Hopi, but we'll get taken down as Volsider gets a double of his own. Take out Swanee and Legends as Trent takes out Hopi.
Holy wow. These teams are just making so many brilliant plays, breaking each other's setups in such an awesome fashion. This is honestly the most entertaining game I've seen all weekend. I'm going to call it. This is going to come down to the wire. Swanee taking control for this Phoenix Uprising. 11 seconds. This should even up the scores relatively, and we will see it rotate over to that church hardpoint, which is, as I like to call it, Shotgun Central.
Well, exactly, and as you see there, Volsider with the shotgun. Now, you got to keep in mind, this will probably be the best one to hold off in if they can get their setup down packed. And that could be what could get them the victory here on this one, as we have Hopi with the shotgun. Nades going in. Might take out Hopi. No, it's outside. It was, he misses the shot. Swanee goes in now as Volsider put a shotgun into his face. Misses the second shot as Trent will take him out now. And Trent now getting these points. 191 to 180 hits. 1 minute 20 remaining. So that's 80 seconds left on the board. Still plenty of time to get the lead as Hopi jumps up. He will get taken out by Swanee and Enigma with the double.
Massive.
Take out Swanee and Legends. Volsider will take out Physique. They should hit the 200s with this one, and it will rotate in 20 seconds, but that 20 seconds could be the game changer.
That could definitely be the game changer. 1 minute left, 14 on this hill. It will rotate to top statue. Look at that sentry gun just getting deployed in the middle of the map there. But the whole of the team, they're not giving up at all. This Phoenix Uprising squad, they know they can bring it back. Swanee getting a massive two-piece on Avant there. He's got shotgun in hand. That's going to be Trent, sorry. Look at that right there by Swanee. Also pick up another player. They need full time. Here come the score streaks. They're going to be raining in on the hill right now. Unable to connect with anyone, but Varsider takes out him. Takes out Swanee. T-Rent, he's going to be inside. Trent, sorry, inside the hill. But rotates around, managing to take out a player. Look at the score. 25 seconds, 10 seconds separating the two kills. The hill is getting contested. They need to go big, and they need to do it now. Enigma going massive, but just gets dropped there. Here comes Swanee in the hill. Can they do it? Unfortunately, Hopi and Varsider both just went massive, and that will
Hopi
make...
Hopi's standing up already.
GG right there. That, Mikester, such an amazing... Hole, I cannot put it into words. That was incredible. Avant will walk away with the victory, making the scores 3-1.
And what a game it was. That was absolutely amazing. And you see there that final kill cam, but the crowd, you know, they were into it. The teams were into it, and how many plays did you see in that map?
Oh, like, they all went off. Look at that scoreboard there. Every single person going off there. Not a single one of them really lacking. I honestly thought that was the most entertaining game I've seen all weekend. I'm sure you'd agree with me on that.
Pretty much. It's definitely up there, if not at number one there as well. And keep in mind, we didn't even see the first map due to it being on the floor, not on main stage.
And you know what? That wasn't even one of the finals of even the winners or losers bracket. That was for the winner to go into the losers final, who would eventually go and play off possibly in the grand final, which we do have a couple of teams still left alive in this competition. But that game was phenomenal. I hope you guys enjoyed it. My name is Will, also known as Dr. Curry. I'm here with the one and only legendary Mikester94, and we of course will be back live very shortly at Plantronics ACL Melbourne 2013.